If you look me korokoro or you hear me whine whine, I be saying you turn that giriba on top of the chairman television station Wazobia Max TV. And this, now that ogbonge discussion show where we say, now the coco when they inside the matter, now we discuss coco of the matter. My name na Ezugu Chukudi. Every Tuesday and Thursday from 7:30, now we dey carry the coco when they inside the matter, come discuss. And we go carry person where submit this matter well to come chook mouth inside. The idea that so that all of us when they watch, we go learn, we go understand, and we go work to see, say, this our country, Obodo Nigeria, the team move, go the permanent site. I know they alone inside studio. Joining me via Skype, because technology don't make this our social distancing thing. They're very, very easy. Now, somebody when we say, he don't wear jersey of political party for this country. Say, no, my people need equitable representation. My people need their voices to be heard, and I'm going to speak for my people in contest for the 2019 election. But we know how things they be. He no win. But he talks say whether he win or whether he no win or he go still continue in good work as he take concern, as he make it represent in people. At the inside studio based on Skype arrangement with Honorable Rotimi Balogun. Honorable Rotimi Balogun, welcome to Coco of the Matter.
Yeah, good morning, everybody in the house. I'm greeting you.
We greet you, well honorable. Done. We greet you. Welcome. Thank you very much. And make I just give background of this our discussion before we go enter inside, because I know say talk plenty for inside where you want to talk for this matter. So now the thing when they run now inside about Nigeria, now NDDC. What's it be NDDC? Niger Delta Development Commission. I beg the House of Assembly, that is our National Assembly, the lower one, House of Reps. Then we come talk, say, they won't probe how then they spend money inside NDDC, especially as it takes concern the Interim Management Committee under the leadership of Professor David Pondey. When they call Professor Pondey, make him come. The first time when they call him, make him come. And he be talk, say, the chairman of that committee, say, they don't call his name for story when no good. And he stand up, in workout. The next time when they call and come, say, you not get right to talk, say, you no go answer us. In come. The chairman say, okay, oh, because you talk this thing, I don't come out my hand. Now, so they begin to fire Professor Pondey, question, fire and question. And then they fire and question. He come, they ponder. When they ask her one question about how he take consign money when they spend, now, so Professor come pause. He come, they go down. Now, so he faint. People say, now question, I make you faint. I've been a real faint, now you faint. After them do everything, when they carry and come out, just come out, say, the AC, when they inside that place, not to walk, heat too much, maybe now why he faint. The Honorable Minister, Senator Godswill Akpabio, he do it all. And he also talk the talk when we say, he shock plenty people. So tell the chairman of the committee called the shout, he's okay. Off your mic. Today, we go talk about NDDC. Today, we go join this matter, and we go talk what is exactly be the problem, and what we go do moving forward. Honorable, thank you very much. Say, you just listen to me as I give my introduction. Make I just go straight to the point. The first time when you hear, say, person faint for probe committee, and how Nigerians take they react, what will be your reaction first to this NDDC matter? As you take concern, I say, they ask person question, infant.
The thing shocked me too, to be sincere. When I see that matter for the television, where the House of Rep investigates the spending on the NDDC, I was so shocked that, which kind of question will make a whole professor, we don't give a enough formula for class to faint. This kind of question get a CBO. Is this kind of, not be the same question that they ask from other of a colleague whether they answer? If they don't get any cocos for their cupboard, why ain't go they form faint? If you spend money, explain what you spend money for. Show us what you spend. Give us the invoice and everything so that we can be able to check out whether they are truthful. That's the way you spend money for a day right, I'll be day wrong.
Okay, Honorable, this one where you don't talk now. Now, like the reaction of so many Nigerians as you take concern, say, then they ask person about how they take spend money, the person can't faint. Maybe we just hold that faint part because nobody most important discussion for this cocoa be that. Maybe we go back to the year 2000 when we say they established the NDDC. Maybe we even check what will be the meaning of NDDC. Niger Delta Development Commission. That Niger Delta Development Commission supposed to be agency when we say our brothers and sisters went there for Niger Delta, where this country they collect oil, they make plenty money, they go feel live their life. Development go to that particular place. I won't ask you, the NDDC, since they formed that NDDC, so he get anything when we say the NDDC don't do and achieve as it take concern the agency of government?
Other, to be sincere, they never achieve anything, neither, nothing. Because you see, this same matter, during my election, when I come in a studio, I try to explain this matter of how Dubai started their economy with less than $15 billion. And NDDC, with a record, have taken over that amount since 2000 till date. Like I'm talking to you, you cannot even see a place that is even close or that looks like Victoria Island in the Niger Delta region. So that means they'll be collecting that money and they'll be sharing it within themselves. They'll be sharing the money within themselves. And there'll be line of projects here and there, projects that cannot be verified. And nobody is going, where are the activists? The activists in Niger Delta, they were shouting, we are marginalized. They don't give us our own. They don't give until Obasanjo give them 13% derivation. So it means that they don't settle all those ones, their voice, they don't lose their voice. Means that they should be among this problem. Because they don't collect money, they don't chop them, keep quiet. The money NDCC have collected would have built about two of Dubai in that region, if really they want to develop that region, sincerely. But you see, the problem we have is when the same mediocres come out with that same money, give the populace, the problem of Nigeria and Nigerians, don't be Nigeria itself. That Nigeria is the problem of Nigeria. Like as I talk to you, so that day when they want to do that probe, maybe they pay some miscreants where they call themselves youth, where carry placards, say, leave Professor Ponde and leave Akpabio. You don't need to ask them questions about how they run the affair of Niger Delta. They carried it and they step in front of National Assembly. They do protest. But they don't know say drama go happen inside there. Say the people they don't collect money, they won't go defend. They're not going to be able to handle the matter. The way they call themselves to handle. Say that there's some go defense, some go turn out to drama. At the end of the day, who they suffer?
Honorable, this question where you ask a very, very important one. Who they suffer am? And who they suffer am? Now, we, the ordinary Nigerian people, in this case, as it takes concern the NDDC, our brothers and sisters, when they the Niger Delta. Make I ask one question before we enter inside one small break. This question get to do with how it be, say, we don't get different governments. And this different government don't put different people today in charge of the NDDC. Yet, we see they get the same bad result. I won't ask you. This problem, when they face the NDDC today, as it takes concern, say, they know they fulfill the mandate. You think, say, solution day, Abi, now because of, say, we be Nigerians, and it get the way when God take create us, we not fit make any solution from this particular problem. Solution day?
Solution, Barakate. Solution day. As we are saying, my brother, if you look inward for our community, we know men and women of integrity that can sit in that position. But because they don't get money, because they don't be set to some big people, because they don't be give kickback, they will never recommend them to be there. Sincerely, me and you from my street, I know the boy will be able to say, this one, no, I trust this one. If you give a position, he go handle this thing well. Now, how do these people become the chairman of those commissions? That who lobbying, that who man no man, that who connection. You're not supposed to be like that. You're supposed to give out the best way people perform, where get the real qualification in terms of attitude. Because there's nothing like character. If you don't have character, if you like get professor, get anything, you will still mess up the office. That character can be human being. Integrity. Don't be all this audio integrity where they shout up and down. Because you know, everybody like to buy us. Everybody like to buy land. Not everybody like them.
Honorable, this talk where you don't talk now, I dey very sure say it go calm the mind of plenty Nigerians. Because you don't talk, say, solution there, solution berekete. You don't even mention some. You say, People when we say get good character, now then be the people who are supposed to take that particular position. Now, what did I go do now? Now to just beg you, say, I beg, just pause. Make we take small break. When we go this break, come back, we'll begin to talk. Say, okay, moving forward. Waiting our House of Reps, then when they probe this matter, waiting they're supposed to look. Those when they NDDC, waiting they're supposed to do. And government inside Obodo Nigeria, waiting then go do to see, say, our country better. Our people went there for our house, no go anywhere. Will they come back? We will continue this discussion as they concern the NDDC. Now we go settle the matter, no go anywhere. Welcome back to Cocoa of the Matter, my Ogbonge visitor, Honorable Rotimi Balogun. Stay there with me, and we'll discuss the NDDC matters arising. Honorable, before we go that break, so you've been talking about solution one day and talk about people when get good character. Honorable, may I ask you this very, very important one. Some Nigerians don't talk, say, even if you carry person when get good character, put for there. If that agency in itself, the foundation, not strong, even that person won't get good character, the person go get problem. Make I just explain quickly. For example, make we look the EFCC. They say Nuhu Ribadu, na good man. They say Nuhu Ribadu, na good man. They say Farida Waziri won't succeed him. He be like, say EFCC don't get K-leg. They say Ibrahim Lamo, they won't succeed Farida Waziri. EFCC don't get good leg. The same people went talk, say Ibrahim Mustafa Magu, na good man. Now they don't begin to talk, say EFCC get good leg. Even I say, if we not build strong institution, no matter how good this person day, if bad people want make the person bad, the person must bad. How you take reason this matter? Strong man or good woman or strong woman with character or strong institution?
Two things they happen. The first one is you have to have a good and strong institution. Now, how do they set up an institution? Because you see, the way this money they take go, if they have a strong institution, they will have a check and a call over officer that will check and call over all those expenses where they go in and out of the commission. So that they will ensure that they meet up to the standard where the commission already set for himself. Even you like, when you bring somebody to come in 20 years' time, there must be a vision and standard and plan for the commission. So when you come, now what you go work with me that? Don't be saying you'll come and start your own work. Because in the list of money they spend, I see one where they even buy for me. They say they spend money for Lansa Beaver. From January to May, where this man, they did it. And we don't say our lockdown start almost like February ending to March. So how did this man money for Lansa Beaver treatment? I was confused. When we got COVID-19, you say you spend money for Lassa fever patient. How many people get under that away get Lassa fever? What you spend that kind of billions of naira for? So when you see it's a system where we have to build strong institution, like for example, now you already see that banks, you cannot even fraud a bank as an individual because they have a very strong institution guiding. Then in the bank, they've created that institution whereby they have to they monitor every expense, every money that goes in and out in the system. So if you can do public offices like that, I believe in the long run, we all will be happy for it. And we'll be able to stop all these excesses of corruption, embezzlement, and this money says, now where the money follow, come out. All this money, what they talk now, which account the thing follow? We have to trace all those accounts. Who they pay? Now who get these contracts? Let's trace it down to the root. But they will not want to do it because some of them are beneficiary of this thing. Look what you are trying to talk now. He said the chairman, off the mic. The chairman took a record, off the mic, off the TV, off the lights. People they would have off generator if they have power to off the generator then. But it's so painful. We can't continue doing things like this.
Okay, we can't continue doing things like this. Honorable. We don't reach where we go carry waka come out for inside studio. Make I ask you two very, very important questions. The first question get to do with how people won't get this integrity now. Go fit enter inside government and how Nigerians suppose they give these people support. Make I give you the reason why I ask this question. He gets some people who go come and talk, say, politics is a dirty game. Good man go look, say, I know one day involved, so that nothing go dirty my good name or anything when go spoil my reputation or image. This thing go they make good people, they run away. Now, these bad people, when they talk, say, politics is a dirty game. Now, then go, they enter, they dirty the team more, and development no go there. I won't ask you, honorable, as somebody when me say, you look, say, no, I'm a good person. I want to serve my people. Now, you make me come out to contest. What will be the advice when you go give Nigerians? When you get interest, but because then they fear, say, ah, now, dirty game, oh, I don't want my person to spoil my name, oh, I don't want this, I don't want that. Now, you make them never they involved. How you go take encourage them to they participate inside Nigeria political process actively?
Sincerely, I've been encouraging a lot of youth, not people individual. A lot of youth, I've been encouraging them to come into the political terrain. Mm. That, you see, there is a dirty game. The dirty game deceive us, see? The dirty game not be the embezzlement, when they embezzle, they kill themselves, they run up and down. Mm. But if you make them say, yes, everybody will get the interest of this country for arts, come out to join this race. You find that those who did dirty, that they will run away. Mm. Because you will not do dirty, you will never succumb to their dirtiness. Mm. You will always take your stand, because in my own area, they say, the name where your papa named you, that you go answer. If they go to that time, well, my papa will say, ah, one more, and he told you, that's when you know the name of who person you be, oh, because that name, they don't protect them before you were born. So you have the duty and right to protect that name. And two, our people have to remove mind for all these luxury things where they jump up and down for. Mm-hmm. You see, you know they pay. Now, what is the cost of? You see, when the society sees people that have big money in their pockets, criminals that have big money in their pocket as their role model, what do you expect? Mm. The good ones want to come rescue them now. There are some people in them say, they don't send that money. That money is so not being they drive them. Mm. They have what is driving them, which is integrity, justice, equity. That's what is driving them. And they will not go to any length to protect it. We know them. But because they don't have the might, they don't have the power, they don't have the connection, we will push them aside and say, go, you don't get money, I beg. Mm. And the money will be after. Mm. So at the end of the day, how do you want to rescue ourselves? Okay, look who are the people suffering in Niger Delta. Mm-hmm. They are the common masses. Mm. The common masses will not get connection to go Abuja, go cry. If not be this probe, say, where they force themselves, where God now expose them, where the woman, they talk this, my minister, they talk that one. That way, my president said, oh yeah, better open the book for them. How we going to know how this kind of thing they happen? Where they lock us for house? Mm. How would they know now? Mm. They lock us inside house. Sky police, they beat us, people no come out. Mm. And they embezzle money, they say they are taking care of themselves for palliative, 1 point something billion naira. Mm. And the people on the street cannot push in 5,000 naira to eat.
Mm. Honorable,
see, today, we just expect the palliative way madam saying go send money into people's account. Mm. They say if you can recharge your coupon for 100 naira, you don't go get the palliative. Mm. See, today, we don't see that money. Mm. That talk we still hear. Mm. So you see, we have to come out. We all that's what drove me and brought me out of this, you know, not be saying it, you know. What did bring me out? Not be money. I know if not about money by God's grace. The little way God do for me, I know who believes I go reach here. Mm. I'm okay with it. Mm. I can afford to tell my family enjoy it. Mm. But I look and say, no, we can't continue running this country today like this. Mm-hmm. If we regret all these children, where we're supposed to develop. Tomorrow that they're gonna attack our own people where we can say we don't spend all the whole money keep up and down. They will attack them to survive. Mm. And it will not be okay by that time. Mm. Eh? If we all this all of them, then they say they'll be progressive. What is progressive about what they are doing now? Mm. Is this how progressive be? You just use words without even having it as an action in your body. Eh? It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. We need to take stand. Now all of us people come out. Mm. Every meaningful Nigerians come and well-meaning Nigerians that want this country to work for their unborn children. Mm. They should not sit down. They should come out. And if possible, those will be saying they scatter the whole policy. Make we push them, shame them, push them outside. Let's shame them. If we hear their name, let's put criminal on their name, chef, before we even call them criminal. Because you will find out they are propping these people. Mm. They will say they're not cheap money. But go to their house. You will calculate their salary. You will see people buying out of 600 million.
Very
you will see people buying out of 1 billion. How much be your salary? How much hours since when they born you?
Honorable, this one when you do, now wait till we go
to call. Yes, sir, you okay. Yeah, you should go say that lie. Get the poor man, never compete them. But what you can cash, what in your house? So how you take that money? We don't say no get any other business than this government business. So when it comes from?
Honorable, this one way you don't talk, now waiting that they call clarion call to the Nigerian people. And I go like ask you, some people don't come and talk, say, if we not put big punishment for these politicians there and public officials when they thief our money, say we not go see progress. Some don't even talk, say, make we borrow the example from China. Say death penalty for corruption. You think, say, that one, he go serve as something when go stop people from doing this badness. If we talk, say, death penalty, don't they down for corruption?
That's one ingredient to that menace where they happen. But me and you know, say, that death penalty, for this country, maybe say, if you cheat Maggi, you go 10 years imprisonment. But if you cheat billion, they go, hey, you say, bail yourself with some money, make they go. You just say that kind of thing will happen for this country. But we don't deceive ourselves, our systems. They have to build a strong institution for that kind of judgment to be able to hold ground. You go see Koro, say somebody will cheat money, when they don't kind of go court, go, and then we try one technicality. Or one technical, they know how they do their technical match, how they play them. You understand? So what I want us to do, yes, is a way forward to discourage some. But it should be a proper auditing system whereby you don't need to move money first before you now start coming to audit. Let there be a control measure where we say, before you can appropriate any amount, in short, let them have a limit to the kind of money the minister can be able to approve out without the consent of the Senate and the president, if possible.
This talk now about the things we go put in place to see, say, this kind of badness, the thing no happen. And it's very, very clear, say, if we get strong laws, when would they push and the thing they effective, we're not going to see anything. One last question before we come out. Honorable, I would like to make you speak to Nigerian people. Plenty of them, then they look the case of Magu, then they look the case of NDDC. Then they look this one, we consign Oga Chris Ngigewe, say, you are a small boy. If you yab me, I yab you 10 times. And then they talk, say, nothing will come out of farm because they don't lose confidence in government. I would like to make you encourage plenty Nigerians today. Just maybe like 30 seconds. Ginger them, say, may they not give up on this country because now their hand, now in the power they, to put the right people for government and also hold those when the government accountable. Again, fire us up, encourage us.
Brothers and sisters in this country, I beg you, you see, we have nowhere to go. If we lose up on this country, we are automatically accepting defeat. We cannot lose up. I understand with you now. Even me, myself, are there, so I have to encourage myself. Say, no, not going back. Now, anything I need to do, we need to achieve them. You see all these things, what they go through, in a matter of time, it go pass away. And I beg you now, but I don't stop. All these case of Magu, case of NDDC, case of the Labour, my brother, we did God, and my God is exposing things for us to see. Before all these things they happen, I will not know. We know they know. But now when God only exposed them, now make we prepare well. Make we take over this country back. From now we get them. The number of people they do all this, they don't reach up to 10% in the country. Now we won't get the 90%. Now we need to come back and restructure our country the way we want. People are escaping out of Nigeria. They're not migrating. They're escaping. How long will they escape? Your picking will never born. You know they try to take an escape. Picking will never know. You know they cannot escape. It's not done. This is our country. We can fight and they cannot let all the mediocres, not let all these criminals, we say, well, look at their background. They have those atoms of criminality, but now I don't know. But we know a lot of money. This money, now they drive us, Nigeria, to where we are. Nigerians are the problem of Nigeria. I beg you now, let's all come together. Don't lose hope. Let's keep talking about these things. Let's keep talking about it. It's 2023.
Very, very true. Honorable, honorable. Are they very sure? Say, you don't over-ginger Nigerians. You don't talk, say, we could not give up hope. And make we come out together to participate for everything we concern this our country. We won't thank you, sir. You carry Waka come. Join us. And you don't talk your mind as you take concern this NDC. God bless you. Our people waiting for us. They talk, say, Nigeria and our country no go spoil. Make we join our hands together to move this our country, go the permanent site. And remember, this NDC matter. Not be about who faint to. Now about development inside the Niger Delta. Magu matter. Not be about who they disposition, who no they disposition. Now about fight against corruption inside the border of Nigeria. Make we they focus on the cocoa when they inside the matter. This fight against coronavirus, one of the cocoa, not to wear your face mask. I don't wear my own. Don't come near me. Don't come near me. To enjoy more of this, our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.